Do you ever wish that the .NET MAUI templates were a little bit more extensive? Maybe it installs a couple of plugins when you start a new project? Well, then this video is for you. In this video, I'm going to show you not one, but two options to get much more extensive templates for .NET MAUI apps, for starting .NET MAUI apps. The first is going to be by Alan Ritchie. You probably know him from the Shiny plugins, the amazing open source work that he's been doing with that. And of course, he's been doing amazing open source work for Xamarin and for a long time. So definitely check out his profile and all the plugins that he has and consider sponsoring them. That also goes for the other person that we're about to see. But Alan has been around for a long, long time. And now also under his Shiny name, he has created a very extensive template package for .NET MAUI apps. It has a full list of checkboxes basically that you can put in there and it will all come along inside of your .NET MAUI application and you will have a very complete project from starting a new .NET MAUI application. So that's really great. The second one is by Matt Lacey. Also, you know, open source out there, longtime community member since Xamarin, now .NET MAUI doing some amazing work and he kind of like followed the same path as Alan, but a little bit different. So I decided to do a little video about this and show you what all the options are, how to get started yourself. Do let me know, you know, in the comments, what do you like or don't like about the current templates of .NET MAUI and what do you like about these templates that you're about to see? All right, let's just dig in. And here we are in this is not Visual Studio. What's happening? All right, so here we are in a command line prompt. This is the Windows terminal. If you have the old school terminal, that's fine too, whatever works. And I'm just going to fire a command in here that will install the templates for Alan Ritchie's thing. So let's look at the Shiny templates first. And what you can do is .NET new -i shiny dot templates. So what this basically does is this is a NuGet identifier. So this just downloads a NuGet package with templates and the .NET new command -i will tell .NET like, hey, this is a templates package, install that inside of my .NET instance on this machine, right? So whenever you do that, it's going to think a little, the following templates will be installed, success, the version number is installed and it provides you with, let me make this window a little bit bigger so that it shows a little bit nicer. So we have like these three templates that it installed. So it's not just .NET MAUI, it's also Bluetooth hosted characteristic. I have to ask Alan what this is actually all about. But the most important one for us here is the Shiny MAUI one and the Shiny MAUI test, right? So there's also a little test project in here. So what you can also do from the command line, but it's a little bit less impressive than in Visual Studio, you can definitely do .NET new, and then you can use this short name right here, right? So under this column, you can now use any of those identifiers and create a new project that way. So I can do Shiny MAUI, and then I think do -n to specify a name, MAUI test, right? So it's going to generate the template like this. Oh, so I got options here as well. You can actually influence all the options that Alan has put in here through the CLI as well. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to show you, because I'm a lazy developer, I'm going to show you in Visual Studio. So let's start Visual Studio right now. 2022, the community edition, you can get started entirely for free if that's what you want. And I'm going to scroll down. Don't worry, this is not a new Visual Studio 2022 feature that all the fonts and the things are blown up like this. This is just so I did it for you so that you can review it good on your screen so that you can read all the things. So that's why it might look a little bit off here and there in the layout, but nothing to worry about. For you, it will probably show up fine. So create a new project right here. And whenever we do, we're probably going to, it's going to think a little bit, you know, searching for the new templates. And here you can see we got a couple with like a new tag on here, right? So we see the same templates that we've just installed here in Visual Studio. So you can see the Shiny MAUI application. That's the one that I'm after. We can also see that device runner one, and the other one is probably somewhere in here as well. But I'm going to click the Shiny MAUI application and do next. Do project two. It comes up with that name. Sounds perfect to me. Project two. And now we get to a dialogue that Alan, well, you know, this is inside of Visual Studio already. Alan just provided this configuration, right? But this is the dialogue that Alan added for us with all the configuration here. So you can still choose the framework, right? So .NET 6, .NET 7, set the application ID. So you can change the application ID from right here. No need to go to your CSproj afterwards or the project properties or something like that. You can do it from right here. You can have check marks for add the Shiny framework. So that adds like all the Shiny bits. Go look into that or let me know down in the comments if that's something that you're interested in. Add a app settings. So Shiny also has a package for reading the configuration from a JSON file. So that's something that is ticked right here and you can get that out of the box. Your App Center key. So if you haven't seen my videos on App Center, go check out the corner of your screen right now. App Center is back, has support for .NET MAUI, and you can input your key right here and that's automatically hooked up for you. So how cool is that? Now let's check out what else do we got here. So we got a bunch of Shiny options. Obviously this is created by Shiny, by Alan Ritchie, so we're gonna have a lot of Shiny. You can add Bluetooth low energy client, hosting, beacons, background jobs, GPS. This I can use this for as a checklist, for a to-do list for all kinds of videos basically. NFC, so you can do all the Shiny things right here. Local notification, speech recognition. You can actually add push notification, so it will probably generate some boilerplate code. You can here also go over like these little things and it will come up with a tooltip with a little bit more information. So add push notifications, and this will probably add some boilerplate code for adding push notifications in a native way, using together with Firebase. It will install a plugin with that as well, maybe. Azure notification hubs, you can get all that out of the box. Authentication setup, you just plug in your Microsoft Authentication Library client ID, and it will probably set it all up for you automatically. That would be amazing. So again, let me know for all this stuff what you want to see down in the comments. But you can see it also has a couple of other libraries that you can install, right? So MAUI Essentials with the Media Picker, the MAUI Community Toolkit, already checked. You should totally have that in all of your projects. So the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit is in here if that's what you want. Add barcode scanning in app. Well, I could read them all to you, but it has this great, great list of plugins. A lot of the plugins that are out there for .NET MAUI right now, you can just check them and you will be added inside of your new .NET MAUI app. So let's do fingerprint, audio, barcode scanning. Let's add a couple of these and just click create basically. And then it's going to create a file new .NET MAUI app, just as you expect it to, just as you would normally do from Visual Studio, but now with all of this stuff already installed. So if we look at like the dependencies, it's restoring them right now. I can go to .NET iOS packages and you will see all the packages that I've just clicked, right? So you will see the toolkit, you will see the fingerprint, the MAUI audio, all these packages are right here for you to use. And if we go to like the MAUI program, then you can see that it's all set up here inside of this MAUI program, inside of your app host builder. So it will have the barcode reader, it will use Community Toolkit already configured. You don't need to do anything basically. You can just click run and it will start running your application. So that's it for the Shiny templates, which is already very extensive. But now let's have a look at the other one. So back in Visual Studio 2022, I closed the previous .NET MAUI application. I'm sure that you can run it and you believe that everything you'll see there. So let's have a look at the other package, which is called the MAUI App Accelerator by Matt Lacy. So you install this a little bit different. You go to the extensions, it's distributed as a Visual Studio extension. You do manage extensions, and here you can search for all kinds of extensions. You can see ReSharper, you can see Serene, you can see SQLite, all kinds of things. But we're going to search here in the app box. Now again, this looks a little bit blown up with all the fonts, so you can see it right here on this video a little bit more clear. And you search for the MAUI App Accelerator. We have this package right here with a little goat icon. I should ask him what that's all about. And you can just click download. But what's happening here, it will download the package, but it only will go through if Visual Studio is restarted. You can see it here down at the bottom with this gold bar. Your changes are scheduled, will begin when all Microsoft Visual Studio windows are closed. So I need to close all the windows and then it starts actually installing this extension for some extensions that's needed. So you can see the installer coming up here. It's going to have to do this thing, read all the licenses, all the release notes, click modify, and it's going to install this inside of my Visual Studio Community 2022. So let's just wait for this to finish up. So the modifications are complete. I can just close this window and I can now restart Visual Studio. And whenever I do, I will see the template. So let's scroll down here again and create a new template. And what I should see now is again the MAUI App Accelerator with a little new tag here, and I can start a new MAUI App Accelerator app, which is still going to be a .NET MAUI app, but now with all the options in here, right? So let's select that, click next. Again, configure all the options as you would normally do, the project name, location, etc. Create. And now I get this new dialogue. Oh my gosh. And again, this might be styled a little bit weird because I have the fonts all blown up. So hopefully it will look a little bit nicer for you. But this is with a, you know, divided in a couple of different sections where LN1 is just, you know, a list of checkboxes, which is totally fine. But this looks a little bit different. So here you can select the .NET version, same as before, .NET 6, .NET 7. And here on the left, you can go through all the steps, or you have this project details here on the right as well. But let's go through the left thing here, coding style. So you can choose, do you want to implement MVVM through the MVVM toolkit? You got that right here. You can click on the details, read all about what this is actually is. Go to the licenses, go to, I don't know, the website maybe. So you have all these things. So, or you can just do the code behind, right? So the code behind as it is from the default template, you just get XAML code behind. And that's basically your thing. I'm going to go with the MVVM toolkit. Navigation style, you can choose for flyouts, completely blank, or tabs. So that's basically a couple of different ways to go about your .NET MAUI app and have that navigation already ready for your new app. You can already include pages. So if you know that you're going to have a couple of pages that you just want to have from your new template, you can add blank pages. You can see that plus button here, and I can add new ones. See, and you can see them here pop up on the right, and you can name them already. So you can already have all your names, all your pages set up, or you can have a different type of page with a list detail or a drawing view. So this is the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit drawing view, and you will have a page dedicated to the drawing view ready for you to go. And a web view, same thing, just a sample one, a localization example, all of that inside of the box, you can just add it. So let's add the localization example, let's see what that's all about, and we get that in here. Now, then we have features, so you can also have a X unit test project. I can just add that, so let's do that and see what's coming up here. This is probably, you know, more features will show up here over time whenever Matt gets to implement them. And here down at the bottom, this is really cool. So he has listed the sponsors that make this possible. So the GitHub sponsors for his project are down here. And if you want to be there, I suggest that you do want to be there, then join them, click that button and figure out how to sponsor him for whatever amount that you can miss. That's really cool for his hard work. Now, whenever you have set up everything, the buttons are a little bit hard to view here. Oh, I see. I should have brought this to the side a little bit. Sorry about that. And you have this create button here, right? So again, it views a little bit weird here, but it's definitely there. So click create, and it's going to create again this project with everything that is set up, everything that you have selected in this template. So let's wait a little bit for this project here to come back up. And whenever it does, we should have a ready-to-go runnable application with the pages, with the unit test project, everything here ready for you to go. So, whoops, let's see if I can get this out of here. There we are. You can see this test project, it has created that here. We have our MAUI program with views and view models because I said like the MVVM toolkit, I want that, right? A couple of markup extensions for our localization right here. And, you know, all the views and all the things. Also, the MAUI program. So this doesn't have as much plugins like Allen's one. So Allen's templates are evolve a lot around like, hey, the plugins that you can already install and configure. And this is more about how you want your project structure to work and the navigation and that kind of stuff. So how cool would it be if they could maybe find each other and create one mega template configurator 2000 for this, so that we all have this in one place. But these are, like, depending on what you need, really cool solutions to get your .NET MAUI app kickstarted. Now, I don't know about you, but I am pretty excited about all of this stuff. This will make it so easy to make a configurable .NET MAUI app if you're starting from scratch. You select all the things, you select the navigation, the plugins that you want, and boom, you have such a complete .NET MAUI application that you can start working on productivity from the first minute, basically. So that is amazing. Thank you so much, Alan and Matt, for putting this together. This is really powerful stuff, and I can recommend everyone to start looking into this. Now, what's next? I already mentioned it a couple of times. Please let me know down in the comments a couple of things. What do you think about our default templates from .NET MAUI? What do you think about these template solutions? And what video should I make more from all the options that you've seen in this template right here? So please let me know down in the comments. Click the like button if you've actually liked this video so that it spreads throughout the YouTubes and more people will benefit and know about all this .NET MAUI goodness. Thank you so much for doing that. And I'll be seeing you for my next video. And might I suggest this playlist right here with more .NET MAUI videos so you can binge watch all you want. And this suggested video by YouTube, which is customized to your needs only. See you for the next one.